your natural nini. Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be unpopular opinions, coronavirus edition. Basically, I have seen so much bad stuff going on with corona at my school and just in the world in general. So I just kind of wanted to put this video out there for one, to let you guys know my thoughts and opinions on coronavirus, and two, I just wanted to do it. So without further ado, let's just go ahead and get started with this video. Number one, people who don't wear their masks. It's not that hard. Just put your mask on and wear it. I cannot stand it when I see people who don't wear their mask at all, or if they wear it, they either wear it like this or like this. Like, your mask is supposed to be over your mouth and your nose, not just your mouth, and not just neither one of them at all. It's supposed to be over both of them at all times. And honestly, I kind of get it. Oh Lord, y'all, my earring got stuck. Sorry, had some technical difficulties going on with this earring over here. But honestly, it's not that hard just to wear the mask. Honestly, I do kind of get it. I see why, because it's very uncomfortable. But if you get a comfortable mask, it won't be that hard to wear. Because this one I have right here, this one is super duper thin. Even though it does keep you protected from coronavirus, it's super thin. And so I really don't have a hard time wearing this mask because it's really easy to breathe through. Like, it's so easy to breathe through because you can see how thin it is. And then the other kind of mask that I wear, I really only wear these to school. I wear the medical kind of mask when I'm going out in public. But these masks right here, I wear these to school. And even the medical ones that I see some people wear, they still have it like down here or just over their mouth. Like, it's not that hard. Just wear the mask, because trust me, if you wear the mask and you keep it on and wear it like you're supposed to, coronavirus cases will go down. But people don't wear their mask, therefore they end up getting tested positive for COVID-19. So just wear your mask so we can have fewer cases. Number two, toilet paper and paper towels. At the beginning, when this pandemic started, I still don't know, to this day, December 9th, I still don't know why all these people just panicked and they just ran to the stores and bought all the paper towels and toilet tissue and Kleenex. Like, I don't understand why they did it. I guess because they thought, even though the economy did shut down, I guess they thought they were gonna run out of those supplies soon. And honestly, they did run out of them. Like, between from March to April, they ran out of those very, very quickly. And they did restock, because in the summertime, when BLM was going on, they restocked and people were still running to the stores getting their stuff, but they did have a lot in stock. But honestly, I really don't know why people panicked and ran to the stores and bought all the toilet tissue and toilet paper and Kleenex, because it just kind of made them look a little crazy just stocking up on all that stuff. But I guess in their mind, they were thinking that the economy was going to shut down and we're not going to have anything to, you know, use around the house that's like paper material. So that was that. My mom and I actually didn't run crazy to the store because she ordered the stuff online. But honestly, I kind of see now why they were doing it, but I kind of don't kind of at the same time. But at the peak of the pandemic, it was crazy. So that's why all of that stuff was sold out. Number three, cleaning supplies. The same thing with the paper towels and the toilet tissue. People were running to the stores and panic getting all the cleaning supplies, because even though when the pandemic started, like maybe a month into it, people had started dying. And so people really panicked then, and they started running to the stores and getting all the cleaning supplies. And so even though my family and I, we stocked up on cleaning supplies, even though we wanted more, and we looked on the internet in the stores, they didn't have anything. Zippo, they didn't have nothing. They didn't have Lysol spray, Lysol wipes, Clorox wipes, Clorox spray. They didn't have none of that stuff. None of that stuff. Germex too, they did not have any of this stuff. And so people were panicking and going to the stores. They were buying cleaning supplies and paper towels and toilet tissue and food. They're trying to stock up on all of this stuff. And honestly, my family and I, my house is actually still pretty stacked and pretty loaded with all of this stuff, because we have like a whole closet just full of paper towels, cleaning supplies, and toilet tissue. So I kind of see why people ran to the stores and panicked when it first happened. But you could not find cleaning supplies anywhere. And now the pandemic is getting even worse than what it was when it started in March. And so I think now stores are still kind of running out of cleaning supplies and toilet tissue and toilet paper and hand sanitizer, all that stuff. But I do see why now people were panicking. But cleaning supplies at the peak of the pandemic, they were definitely on a shortage. Number four, people touching the same things. So at the grocery store or at a store where you have to pay for the cash register or at the cash register, and people touch the buttons when you have to put in your PIN number, what if the person before you doesn't have on a glove or doesn't use anything else to touch the buttons with? They're just basically using their naked hand. Then you come right behind them and touch the same button. You don't know if they coughed, if they sneezed, if they washed their hands, if they use hand sanitizer. You don't even know if they even have COVID-19. And so honestly, I kind of feel like people who don't really pay attention to the pandemic, I feel like those are the people who are catching it, and they just don't care. They just don't care. And honestly, when I go out to school or in public, when I'm like buying something from the store or something, I always take a glove. And if I forget, I wear a long shirt so I can tie the end of the shirt on my finger and press the button. And then when I come home, I just wash that shirt. But some people just don't pay attention to COVID-19, that this virus is serious and is deadly. Number five, big gatherings. People are having big gatherings like birthday parties, and we just came up on a holiday and we just left a holiday. We just left Thanksgiving. People had big gatherings for Thanksgiving, and now we're coming up on an even bigger holiday, Christmas. I already know people gonna get together for Christmas and have their usual Christmas traditions, and that's fine and dandy. But if you want to stay safe, wear a mask and social distance, because if you don't, you are going to catch this virus, and you do not want this virus, because you do not want to die from it. So people who have big gatherings, it can wait, or just do it virtually. Just FaceTime your family members, or via Zoom, do it on Zoom or WebEx. All these different platforms that you can do virtually, do it on there so you won't get sick, because you don't want your family members to get sick and die. Then by the time the next holiday season comes, then they won't be there to celebrate it with you. So please stop having these big gatherings because it's not worth it. It's just not worth it. And I'm leaving it in God's hands to get this pandemic under control and get it right so we can get back to normality. Number six, social distancing. People do not pay attention to social distancing. They don't. They think just because they have a mask on and they're 6 feet away from somebody, they think they're okay. No, you're not. Just because you have the mask on and if you're not 6 feet away from somebody, you could probably still catch the virus. Because what if that other person doesn't have their mask on, or if they do, it's like this and they still talk and spit and stuff flying out their mouth, it lands on you, and then boom, you got the virus. So honestly, people need a social distance, and just because you wear a mask does not mean you are 100% protected from this virus. Wear your mask and stay 6 feet apart. Number seven, deaths. People are dying like crazy out here. They are literally dropping like flies. I mean, this pandemic is so serious. I'm gonna put on the screen the number of deaths or the number of people who have died from this virus. I'm only gonna do it when I edit the video. I'm not gonna tell you guys how many deaths it is right now, because between now and the time I edit this video and the time I upload this video, the death toll is definitely going to rise. So I will put the number of deaths on the screen when I edit this video. But it's just so many people dying from this virus. Now, I can tell you guys right now, from what I know, it is over 200,000 deaths. Over 200,000 people have died from this virus. I'm very blessed to say that nobody in my family has tested positive or died from COVID-19. So I am very, very blessed, because it's December. This pandemic has been here since January. And I am very, very blessed that me or anyone else in my family has contracted this virus or has died from it. But please, 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 please wear your mask, because we don't want anybody dying from this virus. And I give my condolences out there to all of the families who has lost a loved one to COVID-19, because this virus is serious. So death tolls, unfortunately, are rising. But if you wear your mask and you social distance and you wash your hands and you stay away from these big gatherings, then the death toll will definitely go down. Number eight, new normal. I personally kind of feel like everybody has gotten used to the new normal. We've gotten used to wearing masks every time we go out somewhere, wearing gloves, social distancing, using hand sanitizer, washing our hands, all of that stuff. And I also kind of feel like some people have gotten lazy and they just don't care anymore. Like, they don't wear their masks, they don't social distance, and they're still having all of these big gatherings. So I honestly feel like if people just stay indoors and they just connect with their family on Zoom or FaceTime, I feel like we would get back to our normal lives, our normal routine, and not say that we forget that this pandemic ever happened. We could go back to normality just if these people follow the rules, because people out here are not following the rules. And I feel like, again, we have gotten used to it and we've gotten lazy and we just don't care anymore. I care, my family cares, and you guys should care too. Number nine, being in quarantine. So quarantine was really from March, really all the way up until, I guess, July or August, because I think around that time, like July or August, that's kind of when quarantine kind of got out of routine and we were kind of sort of getting back to normality. Not really, but we were kind of getting back to our normal lives. but we were still living in a pandemic. I will have to say, a lot of people did get some stuff done during quarantine, because I know I did. And I feel like quarantine, since then, I've actually learned some life lessons. But yeah, so when we were in quarantine, I got a lot of stuff done. And folks that I follow, I've seen that they got a lot of stuff done. So being in quarantine, I'll have to say, outside of the people dying, being in quarantine was kind of a good thing, because we not trying to get sick out here and die from this virus. So it was a good idea for us to be in quarantine, because anybody got time to be catching COVID-19 out here? We really don't. So quarantine was definitely a good idea, and I definitely got a lot of stuff done and accomplished during quarantine. And last but not least, number 10, going out to restaurants. So since this pandemic was serious and still is serious, when the pandemic first started, my mom and I, or my whole entire family, we really didn't go out to these restaurants like Cheddar's, Chick-fil-A, Taco Bell. All these restaurants, we did not go to them at all, because my mom was scared of the people not washing their hands or not wearing their mask when preparing our food. So we were away from Cheddar's and all of those other fast food restaurants for a good 3 months at the most. And we actually started going to Chick-fil-A and Taco Bell, I think back in June or July, because we did do our research, and we researched that some of our favorite restaurants, they had COVID-19, I guess, protection or COVID-19 rules. And so they were protecting themselves and the customers. So we did start going to restaurants, but the people who go to restaurants like all the time, who go to like sit down restaurants all the time, it's just not good, because again, you really don't know what the cooks and the people back there are doing with our food, like while they're preparing our food. So you want to make sure that you stay alert and you be on your P's and Q's and take precautions, because COVID-19 is very, very, very serious. So I really haven't been to like a sit-down restaurant, only one time during the pandemic, and it was pretty okay. But I would have to say, I have not been to Cheddar's since January, since my birthday, and it's December. And it's kind of bothering me, because my birthday is right around the corner and I really want to go to Cheddar's, but I don't know. I'm gonna just have to be on my P's and Q's and be precautious. But going to restaurants right now, like sit down restaurants, I personally really don't think they're safe. So those were all of my unpopular opinions, coronavirus edition. Much for watching this video. I really hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to comment, like, subscribe, and share my channel, and help me reach my goal of 1,050 subscribers. I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.